kid in this school gets a free breakfast and a free lunch every day. When you talk about how much money the city gets to make those meals, once you take out labor costs, it's about 90 cents per student for breakfast.
And when you look at lunch, we have about $1.50 to spend on actual food.
That's it.
That's it.
Is that enough?
I think it's very, very difficult. I think that the people who are trying to make those small amounts of money stretch and feed all of these children have one of the hardest jobs. It would be great if there was more funding for them.
Marlene Schwartz is the director of the Rudd Center for Food Policy and Obesity.
There are a lot of districts across the country where the rates of poverty are so high in that district that it's just appropriate to provide free breakfast and lunch for everyone.
Chialise is in second grade here at Wilbur Cross, the typical elementary school in Bridgeport, Connecticut. None of them have a full working kitchen. They are essentially warming and serving stations. That saves money on equipment and labor. And that's why all the food for the district is made here at the Nutrition Center.
Meatballs are on the menu.
Meatballs are on the menu. We're doing 13,000 servings of meatballs.
The U.S. government spent $16 billion last year feeding more than 19 million children free breakfast and free lunch. That's just under 0.5 percentage point of the total federal budget in 2014. It starts with Maura O'Malley selecting the menu.
This is May's lunch menu. How many fruits? How many vegetables?
And she puts it all in a spreadsheet to make sure it meets the national health criteria for sodium and fat. Because the schools are K-8, lunch has to be between 600 and 650 calories. And yes, the tomato sauce in pizza counts as a vegetable. But in Bridgeport, O'Malley says a side vegetable is always served alongside it.
Walking through here, I see sugary cereal, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Crunch Mania. Is that a healthy breakfast?
These products are all designed for the school market. They're all whole grain and they're all a third less sugar than the products that you see in the retail market.
In other words, the food companies design the food to match the regulations, but they get something else out of it too.
I think that the reason we have branded food products in schools is because the food companies see this as an opportunity to market their brand, because they know that then the kids will want that brand.
Between the regulations and the budget, though, it's hard to make a complete meal the kids will eat.
How's the food?
Sometimes the food is not good and sometimes it's good.
Sometimes it's good, most of the time I don't like it.
It helps you know that you should eat every day and you should be healthy.
It's tough, challenging, but the kids in Bridgeport deserve it. I mean, they need this and we just want to do the best we can with the limited resources we have.
What drives you?
I'm a Bridgeport native. These kids and their families are my neighbors.
Waith Mitchell went to school at Wilbur Cross.
That's right.
Now he works preparing meals for the students, including his own son.
Is there more need now among the kids than when you were a student there?
There's always going to be need in a low-income neighborhood. The student or the young child will say something to a cafeteria worker that they wouldn't normally say to a regular teacher.
What do you hear from these kids?
I'm hungry.
You hear it a
lot. Or can I have more?
How is this an economic recovery with 1 in 5 kids in America on food stamps?
I don't know how to answer that because we definitely do still have children who are definitely hungry, who are living in poverty.
Despite the free breakfast and lunch in the school, for many children here, it is still not enough. That's why every week the Connecticut Food Bank delivers donated food for 30 children to bring home over the weekend. Margaret Weldon runs the program at Wilbur Cross.
The pack is designed for children to have a snack over the weekend. Easy access. Kids can do all of this on their own.
What do you say? You're welcome.
Food is critical. We have kids that, if they don't have it in school, there's households that don't have it.
Chialise is fortunate enough to be sent home with a bag.
And I do have a waiting list. And kids come to me. And they ask me, Ms. Weldon, can I get on the backpack program? Do you know how I feel when I say to a kid, I don't have room for you, and I know that's a hungry, student? Success is not going to happen if you start at the bottom with hungry children. They are our future. And if right now we can't address a basic need as hunger and feeding, then we need to open our eyes.